Hello, my name is Professor Daniel Hoffman, and welcome to Public Health Epidemiology. I will be your course guide for the next 10 weeks. I've spent my entire career in public health. Before I came to George Washington University, I spent 23 years in the U.S. Public Health Service as a commissioned officer. The first half of my career was spent at the National Cancer Institute, NIH, where I conducted research on environmental causes of cancer. I worked in Japan, worked in Russia, primarily on the effects of environmental exposures and radiation on the effects of certain kinds of cancer. I worked with the atomic bomb survivors in Hiroshima and Nagasaki. More recently, I worked with survivors of Chernobyl in Ukraine, and spent 8 years working in Russia and Siberia with populations exposed to plutonium and chemicals from the Soviet nuclear weapons factories. I bring a lot of experience to this field. Again, I spent my last 12 years at CDC in Atlanta, where I was both an administrator and a scientist. I have a lot of experience conducting epidemiologic research over the last 40-some years. At GW, I've been an administrator, a faculty, and a professor. I was the senior associate dean of the school for 7 years. And it was departmental chair for a couple of years, and currently direct a graduate program in infectious disease epidemiology. I really enjoy what I do. I've been teaching this course on campus now for almost 18 years. It's changed a lot during that time. I'm introducing new technologies to the class. So by the time you've taken this course, you will have hopefully a good grounding in epidemiology, its principles, its methodologies, why it's been called the basic science of public health. So we'll talk about such things as the calculation of rates, for example. What is a rate? Why is it important to measure disease in a population? We'll discuss the various sources of public health data on the internet and how they can be accessed and used. We'll discuss in great detail outbreak investigations. So every now and then you see in the news, there's a foodborne outbreak due to E. coli infection from bad hamburger, for example. Why do these occur? How do we investigate them to prevent future outbreaks? We'll discuss in some detail infectious diseases. Again, a very important contributor to the global health burden. Some of the aspects involved in infectious disease epidemiology. We'll spend a lot of time describing the various research methodologies that we use in this field. So we'll discuss, for example, things like cohort studies, case control studies, experimental studies, and so forth. Why are they important? How do they advance our knowledge base, for example? How is this information used to make important public health decisions, to essentially develop and implement policy changes, for example? We'll also discuss screening. What is disease screening? How do we measure its effect in a population? And so you can see this is a very rich field, a very diverse field. It covers chronic diseases and infectious diseases. It's basically designed to look at the distribution of disease in populations, to measure its frequency, to look at its causes, and then taking this information and doing something about it. And so basically, based upon what we find in this research, implementing control measures to reduce the certain rates of these populations. Identifying health disparities that occur at the global level. Why do they occur? How can we address them? And so you, by the end of this course, you'll have a very good understanding, I think, of the science of epidemiology itself, its principles and applications. So welcome. I hope you enjoy the journey. Buckle your seatbelt.